Northern Sabi Sand has been synonymous with the name Northern Avoca since mid-2018. Coalition of Three lost two members last year, and the last remaining brother, known as Mohawk, has been left to defend the Nkuhuma pride and territory. Since the arrival of two Black Dam males, Mohawk has slowly adopted semi-nomadic lifestyle. Rather than spending his time with his pride, he hangs around his four sub-adult sons from the Nkuhuma pride. Although he's in very decent condition, it seems like he has no interest in fighting the two Black Dam males. Although his reign in the north might be ending soon, by no means does it seem to be the end of the last Northern Avoca. Two Black Dam males have established themselves as the dominant males in the reserve. These two males are in the process of taking over a pride of their own. Even though they were seen with the Talamadi lionesses, the Nkuhuma pride seems to be the one they're interested in. Sub-adults of the pride need to understand that they can't hang around the pride in the presence of these two new males, and they need to leave with their father. A new male, that son of the Orpin Coalition, has also claimed Sabi Sands as home. Black Dam males got the wind of him and attacked him in the cover of darkness. Despite that, the young male did not leave and was in the company of a Talamadi lioness. What future hold for him, we'll see. A little south of Black Dam males, Nzenga Coalition, that started the year as a coalition of four males, is down to only two. First, it was the club-footed Nzenga who died after being injured by the Gijima males and losing condition over time. Then the brother with the long-time abdominal injury, which was caused by a buffalo, died due to losing condition. The Nzengas were not very happy to find out about the arrival of the Black Dam males on their northern border. One of the Nzengas even got beat up by them. But before they could really get back to the new males, the demise of their brothers put a halt on the action. The remaining two brothers seem to be content with the Kambula pride that has a lot of cubs sired by them, and they don't seem to mind the Black Dam males anymore. By no means, this should be taken as weakness, as both brothers are in their prime and are more than willing to defend what they have. Even though the Plains Camp males are the undisputed kings of Western Sector, it doesn't mean that their territory is clear of other males. Despite the countless attempts of eliminating them, the Nkuhuma and Tumbela male are not leaving the area. Plains Camp males are dominant males of the Mangeni, Nkuhuma Breakaway, and the Shimungwe pride. Mangenis and Nkuhuma Breakaway are happy with raising their offspring, but the same can't be said about the Shimungwes. For some reason, they're found in the company of every coalition that crosses their path. When Plains Camp males leave Shimungwes for territorial patrols, Nkuhuma and Tumbela male arrive and join the Shimungwes, which for some strange reason, Shimungwes don't seem to mind. They even were seen with young Talamadi males. The confused Nkuhuma male is stumbling upon potential partners for the past few months after his partner was killed by Plains Camp males earlier this year. He got into an altercation with his half-brothers, known as the Kambula males, who used their numbers advantage and beat up Nkuhuma. He then joined the Talamadi male, but as soon as the other Talamadi male arrived, both brothers were seen chasing Nkuhuma. Nkuhuma then joined the Tumbela male and Shimungwes. For one reason or another, Nkuhuma then once again joined the Talamadis, who this time were not hostile towards him. If he doesn't stick to a partner or a coalition, his chances of being successful are very thin. After all the lionesses of his pride died last year, Tumbela Male became nomadic. Since then, he's been playing hide-and-seek with the Plains Camp males who have caught and injured him multiple times. In recent weeks, he was missing for a significant amount of time before being seen with Shimungways and Nkuhuma.
You got him.
Yeah.
There you go.
The daughters of the Tumbela male, two Ottawa lionesses, have done an amazing job of surviving in very hostile environment. These two young lionesses almost made a fatal error a few weeks ago. They learned about the presence of Mangeni pride that consists of five adult lionesses and for some reason went straight to give a chase. The Mangenis were baffled and they ran away quickly thinking they were being chased by a much stronger opposition than they actually were. As soon as the Mangenis noticed they were running from the two sub-adult lionesses, they turned back to teach the youngsters a lesson. The young Ottawa lionesses thankfully realized in time that tables had turned and ran for safety. They avoided the Mangenis, but got separated. Thankfully, their survival instincts led them to find each other, and they're doing well ever since. The Kambula youngsters that are offspring of the legendary Birmingham Coalition and Kambula Pride are also inhabitants of the Western Sector. These four brothers and their sister are living in the area that's not on the radar of the two dominant Plains Camp males. These youngsters are excellent hunters, and their peak physical condition proves that. So far, they've laid a beating over the Nkuhuma male and have chased the Talamadi young males. Right now, they're more interested in buying their time rather than challenging any dominant coalitions, which is preparing them for the future that's surely going to bring a lot of challenges and opportunities. The Salala lioness, as usual, has kept a low profile. This young lioness has developed leopard-like skills in hunting and avoiding other lions. Her sightings are very rare, but whenever she's seen, it's always a treat. Southern Sabi Sand is the home of chaos for the past few months. Credit of this chaos surely goes to the invading coalition known as the Nakulu Coalition, which consists of five young Nakulu males and an older male known as Dreadlocks. They first invaded the territory of the southern Avokas, but were immediately chased out. They then entered the territory of the Gajima males, but the Gajimas did the same thing and furiously pushed them out. Nakulus went away before once again coming back and killing a lioness from the Sand River Pride. This was probably the reason why Southern Avokas got really mad, as they're the dominant males of the Sand River Pride. Both Avoka brothers managed to catch Dreadlocks and mauled him badly. Dreadlocks and his comrades were not seen for a while as they had gone back to Kruger National Park. Some even speculated that Dreadlocks wouldn't survive because of his injuries, but he seems to be doing okay. His injuries are healing, and he's on the road to recovery. His five comrades, however, haven't completely given up on the rich domain of the southern Avokas. They're still seen invading the territory of two Avoka brothers, which can lead to a conflict. Despite the chaos in the south, Styx and Southern Pride are thriving. The Styx Pride's dominant males, the aforementioned Nzengas, abandoned the Styx and went north in central Sabi Sand last year. Two Gajima males arrived in the area, but the Styx lionesses avoided these new males as their offspring were very young at that time. It seems as though that they've given in to the Gajima males. Pride consists of two adult lionesses and one male and six female sub-adults. Due to the Gajima takeover, the young male of the pride might have to leave the pride or else the Gajimas can turn on him. As for the female sub-adults, the Gajimas are more than willing to wait for them to grow up to become potential mates, just like with the Southern Pride. Speaking of the Southern Pride, this pride is making a comeback we all wanted to see. A few years ago, the Southern Pride lioness was left alone. Coalition of four Nzenga males arrived and sired two female cubs with her. When the Nzengas abandoned the area and Southern and Styx Pride, two cubs of Southern lioness had grown into beautiful sub-adult lionesses. The Gajima males arrived soon, but rather than killing them, they waited for them. This patience of the Gajimas has resulted in more cubs in the pride. The three lionesses are now raising their offspring with the Gajima males watching over the area. The chances of them raising their offspring are very high. Let's hope the legacy of Southern Pride stays alive.